Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Planet Coaster, and today I want to do something a little bit different. I want to show you guys what is in Alpha 3. I will show you all the new objects and rides, and it's a lot, but it's a great way to see what you could actually do with this. I got some inspiration by seeing everything just placed down, and yeah, maybe you guys will too. So I started up Alpha 3 at the day of release because of course I was really excited, but mainly I wanted to try and add the new water to Pirate Haven. And if you've seen it, you know the whole backside of the park is made up out of blue roof tiles, and there were more than 5,000 of them I discovered yesterday, so that is a lot. But yeah, that is something new. You can now click on a building and see how many objects are in there, and that is for the new blueprint system. And you can actually now save blueprints with 1,000 objects in there, and if it's more you have to do it in pieces, of course. But yeah, that is a really great thing to do. Now you can share your stuff with each other, and so yeah, that was really great. I could actually put the water in and it looks amazing. If you haven't seen Pirate Haven, I know I'm very new at this and this is my first series on YouTube, but the park looks great and I'm very passionate about what I do. I'm constantly improving and I would honestly love some feedback so I can improve even more for the next series. It's still ongoing, 3 episodes to go, so I can start a new park very soon. As soon as I think of a new concept and style, that is. But before I do that, I just wanted to make sure that Pirate Haven wouldn't suffer under the excitement of Alpha 3. So most of the work for that is already done. I still have to tie up a few loose ends. But yeah, I do want to start a new series very soon. So first I want to show you when you start up the game, and I can't show you that now because I already did it, but you get to make your avatar now. So let's see. And I would just want to quickly take you through this and show you how this works. There are not a lot of options at the moment, but maybe later, but you can change the skin tone and you have some head shapes, some hairstyles, you can change the color of accessories, some shirts, legs and heads. And you can change the color of the shirts and the accessories right now. So also you can just randomize if you would prefer that, and you can choose your gender, you can choose your age group, and you can choose how you will look in general. I would love to have some more options in the future, like change the hair color. That is just a simple thing you can really personalize your character with, and it just would be great if you can maybe have your avatar walk around in your park or something. I don't know, something like that would just be really fun. So yeah, that is basically it for the avatar. And after that, you had to pick a location on the globe over here, and I chose to put mine right on top of the Netherlands, of course, because that is where I'm from. So you can see there are a lot of other people here, and they called celebrities. So we have a few on here that I haven't even seen yet. I think they added a few, but yes, you can see you have the lady signer you saw on the live stream, and she added Dreamland, so you can now actually download that and add that and subscribe, and that way you can get it in your game. And I don't exactly know how it works yet because I haven't done it, but it's actually a pretty great system. And as you can see, this works for all of them, and yeah, really cool system to see how this actually works and how accessible it is. So as you can see, you have the resume button here now, and you can just quickly return to your game. That way, that is something I really like, just something very simple that adds a little bit of ease to it. And then you have the play button, and you have the game modes here, career, sandbox and challenge. As you can see, career is still grayed out, as well as tutorial and what's new, and of course your saved files. And yeah, let's see, if you click on sandbox you can see the biomes you can choose from, and you have the tropical one, which is the one we already had, and you have the desert one now, and it really looks great. It makes me think of Roadrunner, and it's too bad we don't have a lot of objects yet. I feel like that would fit in a biome like that. I think about dinosaur bones, and yeah, we do have a few dead bushes and tree stumps that are dead and stuff like that, but I would love to see some more stuff that would actually look good in a desert biome. So for now I did go with the tropical one, so you can see the objects a little bit better. And also, as we can see, very soon we will have grassland, alpine and deciduous, and I have no clue what it is, but it looks foresty, so that looks good to me. Yeah, so that is what you can see now. I think, yeah, for challenge is the same. I didn't really check this out yet, but I will soon. So you have my perks here now. You can see all the safes are in here, and I didn't really have to move folders or anything. It was already in there. I did make a backup, of course, because if I would have lost Pirate Haven, that would have broken my heart a little bit. But yeah, the save files were already in here, so that is great. You can see your other saves and everything is in here. So you can see a little bit of a spoiler in there for Pirate Haven with the new water and all. But yeah, you have the downloads tab here, so the parks you will download will appear in here, it seems like, as well as the frontier parks that were on the globe previously. So you can still play on those if you would like to. And yeah, let's go to my parks, and you can see I prepared a showcase file for you guys, and I could also just click on resume to get in there. And yeah, let me show you what I've done here, how I laid this all out. And yeah, here we are. Let me pause this immediately, otherwise we won't be able to see anything anymore. That is something I do want different. I want to be able to switch from night to day. But yeah, let me start with the park management. There are not a lot of options yet, but for now you can see you can hire the entertainers and a maintenance guy, a janitor, and they won't just show up in your park anymore. You can actually hire them now. So that is pretty great. You can keep track of them now, and as you can see, here's the staff list. So if I click on the vendor over here, you can see the happiness and how much they are paid, and you can train them. Also, you see the finance, guests and park operations is still grayed out, so that is something that will come soon. Let's go back to over here, because I do want to show you guys the coasters first. And I didn't do anything special to them, because that would have been a lot of work to see how they all run and go, but at least this way you can see how they look. So right here we have the bar guest, if that is how you pronounce it. But yeah, that is the first coaster I want to show you. This is the Basilisk, if I'm correct. Let's see. Yes, so that one looks pretty cool, looks fast. So I have no clue exactly what they all do at this point. And this is the Looney Tunes, but yeah, I mainly look for a coaster when I know what to do with it. So this is the test pilot. This one looks really cool. I would love to ride something like this. I never actually seen something like this before, so yeah, that looks honestly pretty awesome. Then we have the Tiamat, I don't know, but yeah, really different as well. I'm honestly starting to miss riding on coasters a little bit because of this game. I've been so busy with theme parks lately. And we have the Torque. So we get 6 new coasters, and that is pretty great. I know a lot of you guys like to experiment with different kind of coasters, so yeah. So for the rides, we have the teacups. These are just great. They make me think about Disney, and haven't been there for such a long time, but yeah, it's really great to see they are in the game. And we have the cube over here. This one is pretty damn cool. I would definitely ride that, although with the onboard camera, it kind of makes you nauseous a little bit. But yeah, a lot of seats on there, and that one looks pretty great. Then for this one, this is the Sundial, I believe. Yes, it is. And yeah, really big one, this one. I do love this ride. You can feel the G-forces pretty good on that one. This one is actually pretty cool, and I've never been on something like this before, so yeah, that looks really great. Makes you feel like you can fly, I guess. To experience the feeling of flying would be pretty amazing, of course. So, and then we have the steampunk one, so that is pretty cool. Yeah, I would love to see some more steampunk. That looks amazing, and you could do a lot of cool stuff with that. So you get 5 new rides and 6 new coasters. and that is actually pretty cool. That's it for the attractions. And we go towards the wall types. We have now a lot of new patterns, and as you can see, all of this, I can just select it now with the multi-select, is one set. So that is pretty great. And they are all in this castle-like brick pattern, and I believe we get the same set for the stucco ones, so that we already had. So as you can see, there's just a ton you can do with this, a lot of different shapes. There's more. So yeah, a lot of stuff here. I just will show you them quickly. So this is the more rounded one, and this one has more of a pointed angle. And these ones are a little bit different, as well as the ones in the beginning. The tower pieces are just for this pack. And yeah, you can see these are the octagonal pieces, and those are the rounded. So I put them in a row so you can see them side by side. And some of the smaller tower pieces, and you can all recolor these. So that is pretty great. Then for these ones, I don't think you can recolor these ones. Let's see. No, there's not an option for coloring here, so that is too bad. But I think these ones would look pretty great in the desert biome, so for example. But yeah, the amount of objects you get for this one and the next one I will show you is a little bit of the standard amount of objects you get for every wall type now. So also the ones we already had are have changed a little bit. But yeah, it's a good amount of objects to work with, and you can see here we get the arches too, and I honestly really love this piece. It looks great, and these ones you can recolor, if I'm correct. Yeah, the amount of colors is also just a great thing, and I honestly can't wait to get my hands on it and actually do something with it. And because I did this, I got a pretty good idea now of what I can do soon. So like I said, with these ones, you can almost get the same amount of the stucco walls we already had. And let me show you what we got in here. So you can see all the pieces are still in here that we already had, but they have expanded a little bit. And those are the castle pieces, and the stucco walls here, you can see we have way more pieces now. And yeah, it's just great to see. I think we got way less of the same things to see now on YouTube with these pieces. And if you can recolor them, and yeah, just double checking, don't want to give you false information now, but yeah, you can recolor them, and it's just gonna be a great thing to see what people can come up with, and for myself as well. So that is it for the walls, and like I already said, the most wall types come in this amount of pieces, so we can do a lot with that actually. And then I want to show you guys this side over here, and these are all the roof pieces, and I just set it up a little bit so you can get an actual idea of how that would look. So you have these towery ones. I do want to check if you can change the color. So for this one you can change the color, and that doesn't count for everything, so I believe for this one you can't actually change the color, so there's no options here or here, and you can change the color. So these ones are set the way they are. Then you have these ones, and you can change this one, so that is really cool. And you have the larger ones here as well, and I kind of set it up like this so you can actually see now that you can the castle window extensions you can now place inside of these roofs, and they honestly look amazing. And I believe these are orioles, yeah. So we have a few of them, and they honestly look really cool. So you can also change the colors of these ones. So as you can see, these ones are a little bit shorter, and these ones are a little bit taller. Then you have these ones, and you can also change the color too. You can mix two of them, so that is really cool. You have so a little bit different kind of pieces over here, so you can place that now on the side and make it overlap a little bit like this. Let's put that there, why not, so you can actually see it. And you have a few different of these ones to finish it off nicely. And as you can see, some chimneys here I put down so you can see those as well. Some of these orioles, I hope I pronounced that right. But yeah, and a few more wall pieces you can add to make your buildings look detailed and nice. And also this shape over here, you can't really see it because of the shadow. Let me turn around. There we go. So we get quite a few options here, and we have some of these cornerstones. They look really great, and I love that they stick out a little bit. These ones you can recolor as well, and I just pasted a lot of objects on here so I can show you what is all in here, all the wall attachments and stuff. And this piece is actually pretty great because you can now extend the arches, and let me just select walls and look for it. Yeah, there it is. So you can now extend these arches, and yeah, you can only imagine what you can do with that. You can make giant entryways and doorways, and that will just look so cool. So also this one, I would use it on top of it so you can finish it off nicely. But yeah, another wall trim. This one is decorated, so you can choose to have some more detail with that and some of the other ones. Oh, this one is a little bit weirdly placed, so let me just move that over. And I do really like that one. And there's just a lot you can do with a shape if you can imagine it, you know? So then we have this one, you have the taller ones of this one, and it just works the same. And a bunch of the new wooden style add-ons to buildings. Yeah, then like I said, we have a bunch of new chimneys, which is great because I really didn't feel like making my own, and I did it a few times, but I don't know, it just looked weird to me, and I'm pretty happy that we have some chimneys that look good now. So yeah, we have detached roofs here, and we actually get some scenery items that go pretty well with this style. It's cool. It's something new and a lot of different kind of pieces we actually haven't seen yet. So I do kind of like it, and I can imagine what you could do with that. So we have some roof decorations here, as well as these rings you can add on to buildings now. And a few new of these flat roof types, which most of us use as floors and roofs, but yeah, really cool. So that is it for the roofs and add-ons to walls. And then we have some more stuff over here. So we have a lot of new windows, as you can see. I just wanna be able to click stuff. So we have a lot of new windows to show you guys here, and I kind of put it like where I think it would fit, so these ones look nice together, these ones are meant to be together. And yeah, as you can see, there would be a lot of stuff you could do with this and combine. We're now used to combining our own items, so yeah, that is really great. You can still do that, of course, but we have a lot of more options now. These ones are my absolutely favorite. I just am in love with this. This is totally my style and my kind of stuff, and I can honestly can't wait to build with this. So you can change the colors of these and this one as well, and you can just customize it to your own preference. And a bunch of new doors as well, some really great ones here, and I just love this one and the tall one, and also the tall windows are just amazing. Then we have a few balconies, and they're just very nicely detailed, and I love having more of those. And yeah, I do think that is all of it, but this railing also is just a little bit different from the other one we already had. And you can see we have a drawbridge and a gate, so you can make a castle with that. And yeah, let's just keep going. These are more of the decorations, and I believe a few scenery items as well. So we have a few new signs for outside. Stained glass window of the king, which is honestly amazing. I love stained glass, and definitely for the fantasy theme. So some shields and swords and more signs. And I do think I have everything. I searched really well, but could be I missed something, of course. But as you can see, we just have a lot of fun new stuff to work with. some banners to give it really the castle vibe, and flags, and a bunch of these ones on top. Let's go back down here. We have some planters now, and we don't have to make our own anymore, so that is pretty cool. Beautiful clocks, that is just amazing. This one is a little bit weird, but yeah, could maybe do something with that. Some faces and another planter, and a bunch of new lights over here. So we have the chandelier, and that is one I'm gonna use a lot probably, because that is just great. This one is really cool, the dragon spewing fire, and some candles, and this one is actually pretty cool as well. I just love how this looks and the detail that was added to it. Some crazy weird mushrooms, glowing mushrooms, so it's pretty cool. A flower, a torch, and this one is actually a little house, looks like the witch's house. And yeah, the chandelier. So we have two more, and these are the torches and a lantern tower. So yeah, I'm just really excited to see the amount of objects, and yeah, it's a lot. And if you're still here, I commend you, because you must be just as curious as I am, and a little bit crazy to watch every single object. But yeah, that looks just really cool. Then we have a lot of these objects, fountain pieces, and I tried to actually see, maybe a little bit silly, if you could put water in here, but that is not the case. So yeah, I'm kind of wondering about why we would have just fountains without water in them. That is kind of weird to me, but still, you could probably do something cool with it, and you can probably just place it inside of a lake, and then it would look pretty cool because the water will show through. A bunch of these column pieces, and they are very detailed, so you could probably do something awesome with that if it comes up. And we have these two statues, fountain pieces, the jester and the king. I can only imagine we probably get the king as a entertainer at some point as well. That would be great. Yeah, then we have a cider press. I don't know what I would do with that, honestly, but maybe there is a way to just use it for something else. So yeah, we actually have the yellow gate now, if you still want to use it. I probably won't, because if you've seen Pirate Haven, you know we have issues. There are issues here. So no yellow gate for me, but it's pretty great. You can just now use it if you want to and don't have to. So let me go over here, and we have a little bit of leg spike there. They're cool. But we have a bunch of new trees here, as you can see. And some of them are really tall, which is great. So in all sizes, and yeah, some new trees. They honestly look really great. So here you can see the new biome, the rocks that are for the new biome, and as well as the trees. And yeah, it would really be great if we have more of that stuff, so we can actually do something amazing. Probably some people can do something amazing with a biome, but I actually need a little bit more before I get inspired to do something like that, something so specific in style. We get a bunch of new bushes, a lot of new bushes, some dead ones, and some pink ones or purple ones, and yeah, a few more of these, some cacti, and some topiaries. So this is really great, of course, makes me immediately think about Alice in Wonderland and the maze in Disney. So you could probably do something like that, that would be kind of cool. I can almost already see people making a replica of Disneyland or Disney World. I haven't been there, but yeah, something like that. If they keep adding stuff like this, there probably will be a pretty realistic Disney park very soon in Planet Coaster. So then we have the effects, and I just placed them all down. Let me press play so you can see them. But I just placed them down, all of them, because I didn't really know which ones were new. And I know these ones we already had. And yeah, the electric rod, we also had that. Explosion, and fire, and I do think this one is new laser, but I could be wrong. Some different mist types and smoke types, and I'm actually pretty happy with how subtle they are, because they could just sometimes be a little bit too much. And like you can see here, very subtle, but it gives you a great effect. And yeah, these ones were already here, but we do get some new ones that are over here, and they're really cool. You could make a huge fountain with this and create an awesome effect, and look at these things. So then we have these are all the scenery objects, as well as a few of this and a few on here. Most of this is all in the building section until here somewhere, and these are most of the scenery items over here. So as you can see, there is a bunch of things that fit well together. That's why I placed it down like this, so you could see how well they fit together. And yeah, let's just see. We have the tents here, and you can recolor those, some flags and a caravan, and yeah, a bunch of carts and festival stuff. And could actually make a real cool village with this. And you have the stocks. I wish they could interact with something like this. Some objects I feel like should be interactable, if that's a word, and otherwise I just made it up. But it would be so fun if they actually would hang their hats in there and throw something, fruit or tomatoes or whatever they do. But yeah, a bunch of new wheels. Like I said, some of the more of the attached stuff you could use. If you build a village or a farm, you can put these barns down. See some hay bales and an archery target thingy. So yeah, some pretty cool stuff. You can make a windmill now and a water wheel, and I just love this. The gazebo and the pavilion and the arch over here. And I'm kind of bummed out you can change the color, because this would have looked great in black. Honestly, I would have loved this in black, and then I would have my concept for my new park. But it's too bad that we can't actually change the color of this. I'm really bummed out about that. White is beautiful, but it looks a little bit too wedding-like for me, for what I'm planning. So yeah. So let's go over here, and I'm gonna reset time, because I do want to press play without it getting dark soon. So alright, and here we are. So we have the pirates here, which are amazing. I don't exactly know if I want to put them in Pirate Haven. I really feel like I should, so I probably will, but I don't want to add too much Alpha 3 stuff to an Alpha 2 park. So yeah, I'm really excited we finally have the pirate animatronics, because I've been kind of whining for pirate animatronics in the last few episodes, and it's just because I really felt like that was missing from my park. So you can see here we have the wishing tree, which looks absolutely amazing. And if you would put it on play for a little bit, you can actually see the wind blowing through the leaves, and it just looks amazing. And I kind of wish they would interact with this as well, so maybe they would walk towards it and make a wish or something. And it would be just great if they would interact with some objects a little bit, or had a reaction to an object. And yeah, we have the spooky trees here, and they just look amazing. And you can probably put lights in here. Yeah, you can put lights in here, and they would just look so creepy. So that is really cool, as well as a few of these finds. Then we have the witch's house. This is actually a separate piece, so this tree stump is made for this, as you can see, to put it on here. And I just laid it out like that so you could actually see it. Let me pause this before the light is gone again. But yeah, we have the witch's stuff, and I don't know if this is for the witch, but I just felt like this should be somewhere on here or something. And the cauldron, and yeah, the witch itself, which is animatronic, so that is really cool. And I don't know about this one. This one doesn't seem to be moving, but maybe it's just a still one you can place like she's flying around her house or something. So then we have the dragons, which is so great. It's just amazing. You can change the colors. We as well have some dragon poo here, and as you can see, it's also animated because smoke is coming off it. Like, it's just like really warm and stinky, so that's disgusting. Then we have this one, and this one is eating, and you can kind of just place a knight down there. I should actually really do that, and it looks like he will eat the knight, so that is really cool. Can we actually do this? So yeah, some of the knights, a patrolling one, a guarding one, and this one is just in a standstill. And then we have the sleeping dragon, and yeah, these are the kind of stuff that just really make me happy. Really happy, because these are the detailed things, and you can make amazing parks with that. You can base a whole concept of a section of a park on this kind of stuff. So then we have the few last things over here. As you can see, they go and sit on the benches now, and they will actually sit on the barrel as well, which I really like. Some trash cans for the palace, that one is, and another one, and there's trash in it, which is pretty cool. We have this set and this one, so we can actually use that now. Then we have the new restroom, and we have a few awnings, and this one, you can change the color of that one, I believe. The spooky facade thingy, and another awning, and yeah, it actually is pretty great. Let me just check it, I want to be sure. Nope. Yeah, you can change the color of this one, and yeah, this is just the standard model as well. So yeah. Really cool. Before, you could, as you can see, they are all in a brick like pattern now, and before we had them in all the different wall types, but now you actually have for each wall type, let me see, this piece, yeah, like this, and you can now just place this down and you have your castle shop, or this one. So easy to make it your own like this. And it seems kind of weird to me that the path doesn't seem to connect over there. Do you see that? But I think it works, though. I haven't really tested it. But let's move on here. I do want to show you a few last things, and that will be in terrain. So let's pick a spot here. You can see the water. But yes, Ruffin. This one is new, and it's the only one that is a little bit different. Now we have Ruffin, and it makes the terrain look way more natural. Not everything is as smooth, of course, and this way you can just make it look a little bit more natural. And yeah, that's just really a nice thing to do. I love terrain editing, so... And this looks kind of weird, but you can see how it works and smooth it out a little bit or something. I don't know. So that is something new. Then for the terrain paint, this is the one we already had, as well as this one. You can see the textures are a little bit improved, I think. So we have the normal sand, and this is just the grass one. So this one is a little bit different. Let's see. This is the darker sand, which I really like a lot. Yeah, just another sand type. It actually looks a little bit the same, maybe a little bit of a different pattern. Yeah, just a little bit, doesn't really stand out though. And this one looks a little bit like dirty sand or something, I don't know. And the one that gets it back to normal, so to its natural colors. What is next? Yeah, the water. So let me just show you the different types of water we get, and oh, it's already there because I was already clicking on it before. So as you can see, it fills it up really nicely, and this is just the calm one, I believe. So let me make a bunch more of these, and I think there are four, so let me just do that. Let's see, yeah, that is the calm water, as you can see. Let me put it on play. Then you have the rougher water. Let me click higher. It looks really nice, like it's windy out. And this one is also pretty still. And then we have the dirty water. So Yeah, this one is also really nice. Depends on what you're doing, you know. If you're looking for a more natural look of how a lake or whatever would look, the tropical blue is not always the best option. So I was just checking for in the path, and I think that is all except for the multi-tool. So yeah, now you can basically select whole pieces like this and just move it around, and that is honestly really awesome. It's also a way to save your blueprints, and you can add and remove with this one. Also, you can just hold control if I am correct. And yeah, it's just really nice to pick stuff up and don't have to be so precise anymore about where you place it or how you place it if you work in different grids or buildings. Really nice to be able to move whole sections around. It's not exactly what I expected. I still would like to have a merge option so you can just merge it all in one grid, and maybe that is too difficult, but this is a great solution and it makes it way easier. So yeah, that is it, guys. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. I know this was very long and detailed, but if you enjoyed it, you can support this channel by dropping a like or subscribing, and you can follow us on Facebook and Twitter as well. So thank you so much, and I will see you on the next one.